pretty standard class size is like around 20 because our school is a little bit smaller, so they get a little more one-on-one time with the teacher. But it's very, very high test.
I'm an IT manager.
Are you?
My real job.
the real job.
My real job.
Yeah.
So, you know, this is really impressive to me because I think in the regular schools, they try very hard to teach in the public schools technology, but I think the class sizes are so big and it makes it very difficult because it's so technical and you do need a lot of...
You need that one-on-one.
Absolutely, yeah. Especially in that field.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. So for the computer class, her class is, you know, I think her biggest class maybe 10 kids in there.
Oh, so wow. That's amazing.
She can work it out and she can go into detail and teach them. I know she's doing like Photoshop. Which is, yeah.
Should I
give her
something?
Yeah.
Hi.
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 Okay, Susie wants to know what is it I'm looking forward to change. Basically, we had a huge shift in this last presidential election, and suddenly the will of the people stopped being heard in Washington. So if you look at the polls, if you look at the popularity of the stimulus package, of the health care reform, of cap and trade that are going to raise our taxes, the American people are screaming, no, 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 don't do it. We don't want it. And they're saying, we don't care what these people say. We're going to do what we want. And this is what upset people so much to get them involved to the extent that they are right now, including myself. Because like I said, I'm just a citizen. I'm a regular citizen. And I never had any aspirations to be in politics. But it's my government. I need my rights protected, and so it's my responsibility to do something about it.
How, as juveniles, young people, how can they be involved in government?
Okay, one of the first steps is kind of the environment you're in right now, because you're being encouraged to be involved. But once you leave school, no one is going to force you to stay informed. No one is going to force you to be involved in government. It's a decision you have to make, and it's a decision that you have to be determined that something matters enough to you to learn about it, to stay involved in it. I was never involved in my government. I was on my merry way, going to my job every day. You know, I worked in an IT department for an aircraft repair station in Gilbert. And I was very happy with my life and had no idea what my Congress was doing, what my city council was doing, what my county supervisors were doing. And boy, when I started to get involved and saw the level of corruption that our politics are involved in, it really scared me as a citizen. So I'm hoping that all of you will take the movement that's happening now, that citizens are rising up, citizens are demanding honest representation, citizens are getting involved, citizens are running for office like never before. And I hope that all of you will take that as your cue to leave school and stay involved and stay informed. Every time the city council meets or the county supervisors meet, people are allowed to be in those meetings. They're open to the public. But again, you have to do something, okay? Nobody's gonna come and drag you to it. Nobody's gonna come to your door and say, come on, it's time for you to be involved. You have to decide. These people have my life in their hands. Do I trust them? Do I trust them with my livelihood, with my property? And if your answer to that is no, then you need to stay right on them. You need to be in those meetings. You need to write letters. You need to stay up with current events. And you need to know what your representatives are doing. And if your representatives are not representing you, you need to get out there and vote them out of office. And that's the big movement that we're in right now. People have said, we've had enough of these politicians. We want citizens in office. It is your government. The most important thing I can impress on you today is that this is your government. You should be demanding what you need from government, not the other way around. Government should not be placing demands on you. Oh, I'm so sorry. I, you know, I'm